the rankings came up and Bhubaneswar was number one. So what I have to say about the fairness of Bhubaneswar? I guess Bhubaneswar is always prepared, right? Otherwise, why it should be number one? Right. So basically, before I start, let me just give a background on this smart city, you know, the mission which is happening. It's a 5-year project. There are 100 cities will be getting funding from government of India, and equivalent amount of money has to be invested by the state government, and you know, develop cities into a smart city. Now, smart city, you know, like this name, you know, what does it mean? It is about giving benefits to citizens. That's the way I look at it, and using information and communication technology as a unit, as a tool. So it's about providing better service delivery, it's about providing economic opportunities, and it's about giving better life to citizens. That's it. It is all about that. Now, we are talking about Bhubaneswar, right? And Bhubaneswar is one of the, you know, one of the best cities. It's planned by eminent planner, Bhubaneswar. So it has the basic requirement of becoming smart is in it. Why I tell it? Because, you know, for becoming a smart city, the physical infrastructure has to be in place. So what do I mean by physical infrastructure? It's water supply, it's sewerage, it's drainage. So just to give an example, Bhubaneswar, you know, people get around 250 liters per capita per day supply, whereas the national benchmark is around 135 liters per capita per day. So you can understand that the physical infrastructure is in place. The second part, which is important, is smart infrastructure. So, you know, like what do I mean by that? It's basically the IT connectivity, the IT infrastructure, the communication connectivity, and the communication infrastructure. So Bhubaneswar is one of the first cities actually to, you know, come up with this idea of Wi-Fi across the city. Not many cities in India have actually come up with that. So Bhubaneswar has done that. The third thing is basically the smart applications, which will ride on this smart infrastructure and, you know, enable the physical infrastructure further. Now just to give one example, if I take the example of water, let me just explain what I mean by that. So there is something called non-revenue water, which is the leakage in the pipelines, right? So we have this physical infrastructure and there is leakage. Now we can use smart infrastructure and smart application to reduce non-revenue water. So what does it mean? A, it means better water supply to citizens. B, it means lesser cost to the municipal corporation for drinking water. And C, it means better quality of water also, because you can monitor the quality of water also. Right? So that is what it is all the smart city plan is all about. And Bhubaneswar aspires to be, you know, basically a service industry. It aspires to be an educational hub, it aspires to be a health hub, and IT can play a big role in all of it.